I'm on the play, and yeah, this hand's great. As long as I stop playing against blue decks and make this Anger of the Gods excellent, then this hand is awesome. If I'm playing against a blue deck, this hand is not spectacular, but it at least has double remand on the play. It's kind of hard to get away from that. Oh, yeah, there's a Celestial Colonnade. Of course there is. Let's just pass. Well, hopefully I draw my one Desolate Lighthouse again. That'd be sweet. Let's go ahead and get a Steam Vent here. Draw. Not thrilled with that. I don't think I'm running out Pestermite here. If I'm playing against blue or red, it's easy for it to get bolted, and I don't have a twin or anything, so I'd rather just save it. Because I have two remands. I can fight over it at some other point. Draw. Ooh, I like Serum Visions. Let's just crack Scalding Tarn for an island and cast Serum Visions. I assume that resolves. Serum Visions and Exarch. Alright. Let's stop on opponent's upkeep and just play Pestermite, I think. If I get mana leaked, then that's minorly annoying, but Pestermite is the weaker of the two, so. If I get pathed, do I want to use this ability? No. I guess I don't need to path. I have plenty of lands here. Don't want to untap Celestial Colonnade either. Ghost Quarter. Oh, so I'm playing just straight blue-white. Okay. Well, that's good to know. I think that I have enough lands that I'd rather drawing Serum Visions and Deceiver Exarch seems better. Land. I'll just wait on this Deceiver Exarch. No real reason to play it here. It's not like it's going to attack my opponent to death. Ooh, opponent's missing land drops? Yeah, I'm definitely happy just sitting here then. Come on. Desolate Lighthouse. Oh, no, I am playing as blue or red. They just drew a Ghost Quarter. Oh, I'm not playing Deceiver anyway. Keep all my mana up because I have all these counter spells. Now my opponent's going to have to start discarding, which I like. Well, let's just keep that fetch here. Well, Anger of the Gods isn't great. Alright, now let's crack the fetch since I'm going to cast Serum Visions. And cast Serum Visions. Well, I like Splinter Twin and Pestermite. Alright, let's put them both on top. And play Tectonic Edge. And I guess just pass. Don't need to Tectonic Edge anything yet. Well, found land, unfortunately for me. Let's draw. Pass. I kept Splinter Twin on top first because if my opponent tapped out for something, I could just kill them. On the other hand, if I had Pestermite in my hand, I'd probably want to cast it here. Though actually, if my opponent's just discarding, I should just sit here and not do anything. Yeah, if my opponent's just like bolting me, that doesn't particularly bother me. Next turn, I might have to discard, but would we be casting an Angel here? Or a Lightning Helix? Sure. I'm fine with that too. Alright, end of turn. Let's cast Pestermite. See what happens here. Let's tap a Steam Vents. See if my Pestermite gets bolted. We're getting electrolyzed. Alright, let's remand electrolyze. Looks like I'm just going to get to win here. We'll see what my opponent does. Yeah. Alright. Cool. Sometimes you just cast some Splinter Twins and you win the game. I have some remands. Let's not untap Steam Vents. Draw. And let's cast Splinter Twin, and that will be that. Hopefully my opponent does not make me go through it, but if they do, they do. Alright, cool. I like people who respect everyone's time. So I do want Blood Moons here. I do want Spellskite. Probably don't want to end up with no way to kill Spellskite, so it's possible that I do want to leave like some amount of Twisted Images in. Take out Electrolyze. I mean, I guess this deck can still beat Spellskite, but it's nice to have a decent answer. The other option is to play Ancient Grudge, but Twisted Image is just so much value. I'll leave one Twisted Image in.